In this video, I want to answer the question, how can Jesus be both God and the Son of God at the same time? This is a very important question that Christians ought to be able to answer. Because if you've ever tried to evangelize a Muslim, you will find that they think Christians believe that Jesus is God's biological son.
Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Maryam, chapter number 19, verse number 88 to 90, Allah says, وَقَالُوا اتَّقَذُوا الرَّحْمَانُ وَلَدَا. They say that Allah most gracious has begotten a son. لَقَدْ جِيْتُمْ شَيْئًا إِدَّا. Indeed, they have put forth a thing most monstrous. If anyone says that Allah has begotten a son, it is the biggest abuse you can give to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is crying in the Quran. Allah is crying in the Quran.
The term Son of God in the Bible is not a reference to a biological son of God. The term is a metaphorical term that represents a godly and a holy person. If we were to say somebody was the son of Satan, what do you think that would mean? I think we would all agree that that person was a wicked, evil person. That's what the term son of Satan would mean to our minds. For example, we see Jesus calling the Jews the children of their father, the devil. This is because they were liars, just as the devil is a liar. They were children of the devil in a metaphorical sense, not a literal sense. So when we look at the Bible, we can see, for example, in Matthew chapter 5, verse 9, we read, "Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the sons of God." The Bible uses the term Son of God metaphorically to apply to angels, to apply to the nation of Israel. In fact, the nation of Israel is referred to as God's firstborn son. It also uses the term to apply to the Davidic kings and the Messiah. But Jesus is uniquely the Son of God because he alone is perfect in holiness and godliness. All these other persons and individuals are meant to reflect the holiness of God, but only Jesus reflects God's holiness perfectly. That is what makes Jesus unique and uniquely the Son of God.
If you read Romans chapter number 8, verse number 14, all those that are led by the Spirit of God, they are sons of God. Means if you follow the commandment of God, if I follow the commandment of God, I am a son of God. In this way, undoubtedly, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, verily is the most beloved Son of God. In this way, undoubtedly, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, verily is the most beloved Son of God.
Now, some Muslims will try to argue that the term begotten, only begotten son, is used in the King James Version of the Bible.
Gospel of John, chapter number 3, verse number 16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, whosoever believeth in him shall not die, but have everlasting life. Begetting is a function of lower animals of sex. How can I attribute this function to Almighty God? Who did God have sex with? Who?
Despite the fact that the King James renders the word only begotten, the actual original Greek word is monogenous. Mono meaning one, and genus meaning a kind. One of a kind. So Jesus is one of a kind, or the only unique Son of God. And he is unique. Why? Because he alone reflects the holiness and godliness of the Father. So when the Quran says that God does not beget a son, or how can God have a son if he doesn't have a consort, the author of the Quran is only showing his ignorance of the Bible.